witnesses lang po ang nag-o-oath. Wala po kayong rules sa resource persons. Hindi naman ang budget ang puntirya ninyo. Dahil napakadali naman magtanggal ng budget. What you are trying to do is make a case for impeachment. So may I request to leave the inquiry?
Ito ang AJ Bueno Vlogs.
Mga kaabangers, dumalo si Vice President Sara Duterte sa pagdinig ng House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability kahapon para sa deliberasyon sa proposed budget ng Office of the Vice President. Sa pagpapatuloy ng pagdinig, tumanggi si VP Sara na manumpa kung saan kwestiyon niya ang rules ukol dito ng nasabing komite. Aniya, siya ay inimbitahan bilang resource person at hindi witness. At batay sa rules ng komite, tanging ang mga witness lang ang dapat na manumpa. Matapos ang ilang talakayan sa nasabing issue, ay nagpa siya ang chairman ng komite na igalang ang desisyon ni VP Sara.
To all the resource persons invited, kindly stand up and raise your right hand, please. Representatives and resource persons from the Office of the Vice President, COA, and DBM po. Thank you, ma'am.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, the Honorable yes. Vice President.
When you sent a letter to the Office of the Vice President, you attached a copy of the rules in aid of legislation?
Yes po.
Yes, sir. Nakalagay po doon na witnesses lang po ang inu-oath. Sabi niyo po, ngayon sa amin, resource persons kami.
Ang ano po, considered as resource person po?
Ang ano po?
Kayo po.
Kaya nga po.
Yes po, lahat po ino-out po.
Yes, apo. Nakalagay po sa rules ninyo, witnesses, nakalagay po dito ngayon sa table, resource persons.
Lahat po considered as resource person and witness. Lahat po naman kayo, lahat resource person pa eh. Wala pa naman po tayong tinatawag na... Lahat po considered as resource person pa lang po.
Right. Opo. Ang nasa rules ninyo, witnesses lang po ang nag-o-oath. Wala po kayong rules sa resource persons.
Ma'am, ano lang po 'yun eh. Yung term lang po 'yun eh, pero considered as a resource person din po kayo eh.
Yes, sir. Resource persons nga po
kayo,
nakalagay
witness
dito.
Witness din po at saka resource person po.
Hindi niyo po sinabi na witness ako. Sinabi niyo po dito ngayon resource persons. Ang nakalagay po sa rules ninyo, witness.
Comsec, ano po yung pinadala po ninyo?
Yun pong rules in aid of legislation.
Sa puntong iyon ay kinampihan si Duterte ni dating Pangulo at ngayon ay Pampanga Representative Gloria Macapagal Arroyo na naglatag ng pahayag noon ni dating Senador Miriam Defensor Santiago at desisyon ng Supreme Court.
Chair, point of order.
What is the point of order of the Honorable Congressman Macapagal?
About witness, resource person, etc., etc.
Ma'am? Ma'am, pakilakas lang po, hindi po marinig.
Persons and accused has been taken up in previous legislative inquiries in aid of legislation. I want to quote a December 8, 2008 hearing in the Senate where Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago issued had an opinion on a similar situation, but she quoted a Supreme Court ruling. So, the Constitution provides that no person shall be compelled to be a witness against himself. The Supreme Court has repeatedly emphasized that there is a difference between a mere witness and the accused. And it can appear from statements and privileged speeches that there is that a person who is the subject matter of an adverse of adverse privileged speech is not a mere witness or a mere person of interest, meaning a suspect. She is in fact accused of what seems to be a criminal case for violation of certain criminal laws, including malversation of public funds. And there is a case quoted in 2007, Standard Chartered Bank versus the Committee on Banks, where the court repeated the rule that an accused occupies a different tier of protection from an ordinary witness. So where the court said, Supreme Court said, whereas an ordinary witness may be compelled to take the witness stand and claim the privilege at each question requiring an incriminating answer is shot at him, an accused may altogether refuse to take the witness stand and refuse to answer any or all questions. So that has been a supreme. And then there is a portion that the court explained that the right of the accused against self-incrimination also applies to respondents in administrative investigations such as legislative inquiries in aid of legislation. So that is the point of order I am raising, and there is a Supreme Court ruling to this effect. Thank you, Mr.
With that, the chair declares 1 minute suspension. Recess.
Mr. Chair, yes. Mr. Chair.
Session resumes.
Mr. Chair, may I speak?
You will be given the opportunity later, okay. Madam Vice President. In any event, the point of the Honorable Arroyo is well taken, but we will proceed to the outtaking. If the Vice President refuse to take her oath, we will respect that.
Malinaw para kay VP Sara na ang pagdinig ay walang kinalaman sa pagbalangkas ng kailangang panukalang batas, hindi rin tungkol sa tamang paggastos sa pera ng taong bayan at pagsusulong ng tamang pamumuno. Naniniwala din si Duterte na punterya din ng pagdinig ay ang pag-atake sa kanya ng mga kongresista na makapaglatag ng basihan para sa hangaring impeachment laban sa kanya. Layunin din umano ng pagdinig na sirain ang kanyang opisina para hindi siya makaporma sa 2028 presidential elections. Dagdag pa ni Duterte, wala siyang ginawa na mali at ang kanyang opisina sa paggastos ng budget at nakasumiti na din umano siya ng report sa COA o Commission of Audit.
Mga kababayan, ladies and gentlemen, assalamualaikum, warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Madayaw, umayong adlaw, kaninyong tanan, magandang araw sa inyo lahat. The officials of the Office of the Vice President as well as each and every one of our satellite office leads were in receipt of a letter from the Chairman of the Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability dated September 13, 2024, requesting our presence or that of our duly authorized representatives in today's initial deliberation with preliminary determination on privilege speech number 379. In view of the said letter, I am appearing before you today not only as the head of office, but more importantly as the duly authorized representative of all officials of the OVP. Simply because we have not done anything wrong. There is no misuse of funds. If there are audit findings, we shall gladly respond to them before the Commission on Audit. And if there are legitimate cases to be filed, then we shall gladly respond to them before the appropriate courts. In relation to this, may I just say that I take notice of the opening speeches and nasabi doon, there is a determination of misfeasance, nonfeasance, and malfeasance. And those are cases that should properly be taken in the courts of law. What we are witnessing now is no ordinary legislative inquiry. This exercise is a well-funded and coordinated political attack. This much is evident from the very words of the privilege speech that prompted this inquiry. A speech that simply meant to say, do not vote for Sara on 2028. It is clear to me that this inquiry is not about misused funds, accountability, or governance. Instead, it is solely aimed at discrediting my name and my office to prevent future political contests. I have publicly stated my reasons as to why I've chosen not to defend the OVP's budget proposal for 2025. I have narrated the issues I encountered in previous years, which can easily be confirmed by looking at the NEP, the GAB, and the GAA for fiscal years 2023 and 2024. Further, I have even shared the drama that transpired last year regarding the confidential funds. Hence, just as we have done last year, we again leave the 2025 OVP budget to the pleasure of Congressman Martin Romualdez. I am not asking for any special treatment, nor am I asking you to uphold any tradition. There is no disrespect. All I am saying is that you have the complete freedom to do whatever you wish with the OVP budget. If you feel that all the documentary submissions are not enough, then by all means, huwag kayo magbigay ng budget. Sa totoo lang, hindi naman ang budget ang puntirya ninyo. Dahil napakadali naman magtanggal ng budget. What you are trying to do is make a case for impeachment. Hindi naman ako kakandidato sa nalalapit na eleksyon. Hindi ako namumulitika. Ang ginagawa ko lamang ay ang pagtupad sa aking oath of office at campaign platforms na trabaho, edukasyon, at mapayapang pamumuhay. Sinabi ko na noon at ilang beses ko nang inulit na hindi ako ang problema ng bayan na ito. Ang totoong problema ng bayan ay kagutuman, kahirapan, illegal na droga, kriminalidad, terorismo, hindi na sapat na healthcare, kalidad ng edukasyon, kawalan ng plano ng infrastruktura para sa disasters, at marami pang iba. So, you may try to destroy me, you can skin me alive, and throw my ashes to the wind. But let it be known, you will find me unbowed. I will continue to serve the Filipino people no matter the personal cost or political intrigue. Having said that, I will not allow myself to be subjected to an inquiry based on an empty privilege speech just so you can attack me and do indirectly what you failed to do directly during the budget hearings. I therefore request this committee to terminate this inquiry for its clear lack of any proposed legislation or substantive matter for discussion. Shukran.
Samantala, wala ding magawa ang mga kongresista nang humiling si VP Sara na umalis na sa pagdinig.
Approach the table. Request 1 minute suspension.
The chair declares 1 minute suspension. Session resumes.
Mr. Chair, may I request...
The Honorable Vice President is recognized.
Thank you. May I request to leave the inquiry?
Ma'am, pwede naman po, considering na hindi naman din po kayo naka-out and alam naman po namin marami rin po kayong ginagawa, the Vice President is excused.
Thank you.
Thank you, po.
Thank you, everyone. Good morning.
1 minute suspension is declared by the chair.
Hello mga kaabangers! Inaanyayahan ko kayo na manood ng aming vlogs araw-araw tungkol sa issue ng mga nangyayari sa ating bansa. Iba na ang may alam. So paano? Hihintayin kita dito lamang sa AJ Bueno Vlogs.
Napanood niyo ba ang buong balitang ito? At nais niyo bang makapanood ng bagong balita araw-araw tungkol sa nangyayari sa ating bansa? Ang gawin mo lang, pindutin ang subscribe red button sa baba at huwag mo rin kalimutang pindutin ang bell icon, pati na rin ang nakasulat na all para ma-update ka sa aming mga bagong videos. Maraming salamat, kaabangers!